Is everybody else as tired as I am? You shouldn't be, because Nathan Fillion is right there. I don't know how much five-hour energy a human being is allowed to consume in 4 days, but I'm well past the legal limit. I am done. And coffee and Red Bull. I don't need that. Who's been to a panel other than this one at Nerd HQ this weekend? From the bottom of my heart, it means so much to me that you guys have done that. You've been here with us. Have you enjoyed those panels? Have you enjoyed them? Was anybody here a Doctor Who last night? How insane was that? Awesome. Okay, listen, I'm going to stop talking because I can't stop talking because I always have these things and then I forget to do them. Could you, Dave, would you take? Hey, let's hear it for Dave Coleman. How about, huh? I have all this stuff and I always forget. Oh, crap. Hey, Nathan, yell out a number. 61. Who's 61? Hey, lady in a tiara. Best Buy is graciously giving you a $100 gift card, darling. Thank you, and thank you to Best Buy. Oh, and then, he's a giver. Did you guys know about how Intel jumped in this weekend? Did you guys hear about this? So they're, right, how awesome is that? So, my due diligence from Intel. Tweet us your best photo from Comic-Con for the chance to win a Vizio Ultrabook. Just use the hashtag Intel Comic-Con moment with your pick to enter. For those who don't understand what that means, Intel is going to match the $5,000 raised in this panel right now and every panel after this as well. So that's for them. Two more points of business. Is there flash photography allowed at this panel?
No.
Is there video allowed at this panel? And for you guys on other websites right now ripping these panels, please don't do that. Please, say please don't do that.
Please don't do that.
Oh, the power of a microphone. All right, well, listen, I've said it before and I hope to say it for many years. He's one of the coolest guys I've ever known. He's incredible. In fact, it makes me sick how charming he is. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Nathan Fillion.
He said, no more kisses. That's fair. But I did brush my teeth. Hello, everybody. How are you? Good morning. Good morning. I did a little something special for you today. Washed my hair. You're welcome. I forgot something. I was going to kind of intersperse today with, I mean, we're raising money, a lot of money. Nerd Machine has raised, I want to say, over $100,000.
I think, yes, let's just say that for now, yeah. I have no idea.
More than double what you guys were doing last year. Fair enough. For Operation Smile, and that's you guys. So interspersed with today's panel and our discussion and our time to connect, this is our time. I was going to take a couple of items that I have with me, and if you want them, I was going to sell them to you. And for a modest fee, give some money to Operation Smile. Starting with my lanyard, for my credentials I had, it's Gryffindor. Not to be confused with my brother's Slytherin. He almost got Hufflepuff. It was close. I think this could go for $5, if anybody, five. How much? 20 bucks? 30.
This is insane. Let's do this right now. I hear 30. I hear 30. Do I hear 40?
50? We got 50 right here. Who got 55? 60. 60 going once? 60 going what?
$100.
For $100, I'll sign that. Zach, would you sign that too?
Yes. Let me get your copy.
$100. Right now, a third world kid is gonna get half a smile. Don't worry, we got more to go. We have some questions, I'm sure. There's a burning question. There's something inside you that you want to know. And it's deep inside, but it's coming up like my breakfast burrito. That's actually not fair. It's fighting. I don't know which end is going to happen right now, to be honest. Who's got a question? The first question is over here. Perfect. Go.
Hi, Nathan.
Hi, Angel. I like your shirt.
Thank you. Hi, guys. I know people here. My question is...
Nice.
Inquiring minds want to know, not for myself, what is your ideal date night and who is it with?
My ideal date night... qualities I find attractive in a woman. Someone who's obviously crazy about me. I've noticed over the years, I'll say, that girl, she's got something. She's got something when they like me. My ideal date night is one where I don't humiliate myself. And here's a story. I think I've told this before, but don't stop me. I had a super big crush on this girl for years. And she was suddenly single, and I was single, and we were at the party at the same time, and it was her and her super attractive friend, and I'm telling jokes, and I'm laughing, and everything's going great, and I'm going, this is great. And I had a cocktail in my hand, I was cool, and it was smooth, which is rare for me. And I went to take a drink, and I realized I forgot my drink had a straw in it. It went straight up my nose and touched the inside of my right eye. Ah! And you know, you ever pick your teeth with a straw? They're not dull. I heard it in the bones of my cranium. And I pulled the glass away, and the straw remained in my nose. Through the cloudy tears that blurred my vision, I saw two people go, I reached up, and to my horror, I had to pull hard to get this thing out. And I said, I'm just gonna go check for blood. So if that doesn't happen, I call that date a success. Next item up for bid. This is an Xbox controller with the Batman Arkham City theme. I wasn't in Batman Arkham City, but Stana Katic was, and I made out with her. So, the pen is right here.
Yep.
I say this is worth $5.
Oh, we got 50.
Bucks.
We got 50 right there. 50 right there.
60.
80. 80.
$100.
$120.
$130.
It's $120 plus 80 Canadian? Oh. Hold on. I think she's...
I'm a Canadian, so 120 and 80 Canadian, that's 125. To be fair, plus change.
I do have to check with Op Smile. I don't know if they take loonies or toonies. That's the only, we'll figure that out. That's good.
We're going to save $11 million a year because we don't have any pennies
anymore. That's about a 120. Anybody got better than 120? Going once. Huh?
130?
140? 150?
Australian money is very pretty.
International House of Pancakes? What is going on? What was it? What was that last one? 150 plus 90 Australian?
I'd say take it. You better take it.
I don't know what Australian money is worth.
Australian money is worth more than the American dollar.
It's like $1 million? You guys are doing very well down under. That's. I think it's a going once, going twice.
That'll do it.
Sold for it. Australian money.
Excellent question. Who's next with a question? Who's in control of the microphones with the questions? Point to the perfect. Hello, young lady.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm so glad we're here today.
You and me both.
So you've played a number of different characters.
This is true, everyone.
And I know that there's a lot of Firefly fans in the audience.
Excellent taste.
But I have to confess, I've only seen like a half an episode of Firefly.
Whoa, no judgment, it's Comic-Con. Really?
However, I have seen you in Castle.
Oh, yes.
And I'm sure everybody from Firefly that likes Firefly really enjoys you coming back to the screen.
They should.
So one of the things I love about Castle is your relationship with Alexis. Can you tell me a little bit about how...
With my relationship with...
With Alexis, your daughter on Castle.
If Molly Quinn were here, she could tell it better. Speak of the devil, you guys. Molly Quinn is here.
I just teleported here from LA. I heard my name and I was like, hey.
That stuff happens. Molly, Alexis, TV's Alexis. When we're taking the, if you can, in as few words as possible, no, stretch it out. Are you having a good time on Castle?
Oh, well, of course I'm having a good time on Castle. I love working with you.
That's right.
And doing things with you.
True.
You're so handsome.
That's three. Wait for it.
And Firefly is awesome.
There we go.
Acting is not rocket science and it's not heavy lifting. The hours are long and it can be draining. The days I have when I'm working with Molly are the closest things I have to a day off. Because it's easy. It's easy. The only problem I have with Molly is when she's cleverer than me. And she knows that she's not supposed to do that. But she comes up with some really good ideas for some really awesome scenes, and she's kind enough to let me take credit.
This is true, because he pays me to let him take credit.
Well done, Molly. Thank you for coming. The next item I have here. Never been worn. Only slightly musked. I believe you'll recognize this if you've had a bowl of Lucky Charms. That's not, no, wait. That's Green Lantern, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Green Lantern. think that's worth $5.
$20.
Are the numbers going up and down? I'm confused. 65. Wait, I had 60. Well, I'm sorry, you have 100 back here, 100 back there? 120, 130. Don't stop now. 150 if he signs it as well? Ollie?
If I what?
Oh, if Molly signs it. What about Ollie? You don't like Ollie? That's messed up. Molly, would you sign this shirt? Is Molly still here?
I'm going to answer for Molly. No. I mean, yes. There's a pen right there on the.
Anybody else? 180?
Nice. 300? $300. That's $300.
I mean, should I just call it?
I think so.
300 sold.
Bam. That was fantastic. Next question. Let's keep it rolling. Who's got the next one? Who's got the, who am I looking at? Who's got the microphone? You do. You're looking around. Who? Who could it possibly be?
I have one of many, apparently.
Nice.
Thank you first for being here, because we almost missed your panel due to the tickety stuff. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Last year when you were here, you were super excited about Game of Thrones. I was just wondering how you're still feeling about the show and the books and all that. And second part, what was it like kissing Zach?
Both fair questions. Game of Thrones, first season, I think we can all agree, excellent. If you read the books, very good job condensing story to fit it all into 10 episodes. Only thing that was kind of eating at me was the Starks wolves, they're using dogs. And in the books, if you know, everyone talks about how big these things are and how intimidating these things are. And they're always right next to the kids, and they're always, it's just like they're reading those kids' minds. They're just so connected to these wolves. Finally, season two, Rob Stark, whom I met the other night, right here. All right. Rob Stark's got Jaime Lannister in the cage, and he's tied to a pole, and Jaime Lannister insults Rob Stark, and Rob Stark just kind of looks off behind Jaime Lannister just a little bit like this, and you hear this deep rumbling growl, and Jaime Lannister goes and then you see the camera panning behind Jaime Lannister but looking down at him, and Jaime Lannister's looking out through the cage, and he just sees this wall of fur, but he's looking up at it, and then in through the door right up beside Robb Stark is this massive direwolf. I'm done. Loved it. Kissing Zach? Agreed. It tickled. And I can tell you this. Zach has a smell. He smells like confidence and cherries.
I'll take it.
Next item up for bid. Oh, it's going to be a doozy. It's going to be a doozy. Get a little captain in you. 100. 260, did I hear?
200.
We got two.
Sir, unfortunately, Operation Smile can do nothing with your soul. I'm sorry. That.
Hold on.
That's very generous.
I know a trick or two. Do we have 260?
260, right.
300. 320. 320. You will make it $1,000 if I give you a kiss and the shirt. And the shirt? I'm going to do that. Please come up here, young lady. What's your name? That's what I thought.
Is Lana? Is that what you said?
Lana, if you wear this, it'll be better for me.
Lana, no pressure, but I taste like confidence and cherries. So, the floor is yours.
Smell like confidence and cherries.
I smell. Smell, taste, come
you
on.
You taste like sneakers and running shoes. New running shoes.
Oh, thank you.
Cheers. Could we have some music, please? Something soft and a Barry White, perhaps. Happened. Next question. Who am I looking at? Who's got the microphone?
I have the microphone here.
I hear you.
I'm over here. Hello.
Can you be more specific? Am I pointing to you now?
I am on the other side. Hello, Nathan.
There you are.
Hello, Nathan. That's a tough act to follow, I have to say. Nathan, you are, of course, a beloved geek god to all of us here. But
Right.
But I understand you're also going to be playing a Greek god in an upcoming movie.
This is correct.
Can you tell us a little bit about that experience and if we can look forward to some scenes with you and Anthony Head in this movie?
Oh, I wish. Tony Head, what a charming bastard. Actually, I'm glad. I'm glad I'm not in a scene with him because he will outshine you in a heartbeat, that kid. I did 2 days of work, one scene, on the next Percy Jackson, Sea of Monsters. I play Hermes, the Greek messenger god. Spoiler alert to you mortals, I'll simply look like a UPS guy. Completely true. A wonderful bunch. Gosh, I saw the first movie and it looked like they were having a lot of fun. I had a meeting with this director, young guy, super cool. We were having breakfast out in the Valley area. And he said, oh my God, my brother would be geeking out right now because he's such a big Firefly fan. And I said, he'd probably have a heart attack because that's Marina Baccarin right behind you. And she just walked in the door at that moment with one of Zach's friends right here. With you. You two came in for breakfast, and you were right behind. You remember? That guy's name was Tor. I was having breakfast with that director that day. That's when he asked me to do this show. True story. The next item. That's my hat. That's my this. What do we got here? This scarf is a Slytherin scarf. I purchased this at Leavesden Studios. That's in England. That's where they have all these sound stages where they filmed Harry Potter. Sound stages A through I, they had to build two more to house all the sets and props and costumes and wigs. Guess what they called those two sound stages? J and K, guys. J and K, Rowling. Had a great time, and then later on that night, had dinner with Matt Lewis, that some of you might know as Neville Longbottom, who turned out to be, right? Because he started out for like this cute little pudgy little kid, and then he became this kind of lanky, kind of goofy looking kid, and now he's like a young Clive Owen. That guy is freaking handsome. I'm not gonna go on. I say this is worth $5. $50. Who said 200? $200. You're so Slytherin. Going once, going twice, a lot of Gryffindor in here, it's yours. There you go.
No, I love that everybody's just waiting for something to be said. It's not going to happen.
But I read it, so. All right, next question. Who has the mic? Who has the mic?
Hey, Nathan.
Hey. Yeah, so A. Nathan doesn't really tell me where you are. Just so you know. Just a name. It's all microphones. So, okay.
I just want to say it's great to be here with you.
Before you go on, thank you. And I love your shirt.
Thank you. Question is, any news on Uncharted, the movie?
Here's what I know. I missed a chance to voice the character for the video game and to do all the motion capture, which I, in my mind, would have assured me a chance at a major motion picture if Uncharted became one. The fact of the matter is, they're gonna get a big old movie star to do that movie, right? You know what's gonna happen, right?
Marky Mark.
I love that man. And I gotta be honest, there's probably gonna be a lot of stunts and stuff, and my knee, my neck, shoulder, I can't do that. I don't think I'm gonna, it's not really, I don't think that's in my, one day, maybe, an older Indiana, perhaps. Everyone wants their Indiana Jones. I don't think that's gonna be, people always ask, and I always, you know, then when I tell them no, they say, man, like I let them down. But I would love to, but I don't think that's gonna happen.
Thank you, and God bless you, and long live the brown coats.
That's nice. I like it when people say that. I have here the Combat Evolved, the Halo Anniversary Special. I voiced some character for this game. I think it's worth $5. Zach, could you pull that open?
Yes, I can absolutely pull you open.
100, I heard. 150? 150 going once? 150, tell you what, someone said 100. Who said 150? 150? Who said 100? I'm gonna give you one for 100. I'm gonna give you one for 100 because I got two. How about that? Two of those, and we'll sign those for you. Okay, perfect. Nicely done. Next question. Who's got the mic? You've got the mic. Perfect. Thank you.
How's it going?
Good. And you?
I'm doing awesome. Fully
glad to hear that.
Actually, I have a question on behalf of my 7-year-old son who couldn't make it to this panel.
Okay.
But you actually met him 2 years ago. He dressed up as a little Malcolm Reynolds. That's right. And you posted him on your Twitter account, which was super awesome. And then last year on G4, you even talked about him. So my son has a huge ego now, thanks to you. So.
Is that a bad thing, really?
No. It's cool. But his question is, and this is really important to him, so think about it before you answer.
I can think.
Okay. Who would win in a fight? Malcolm Reynolds or Han Solo? Explain your answer.
Malcolm Reynolds, because he would shoot first. Ouch. Even I say ouch, right? What was your name? And your son's name was? So Logan didn't throw that costume together himself. You helped him out with that? That's really kind of you guys. I tell you what, when you see Logan, you'll see him again? I want you to give him this Justice League Doom I did some voiceover for. And these are the 3D glasses they gave us when I went to the Spider-Man premiere, the Spider-Man 3D premiere. Give him those for me. The next item, up for bid. This only slightly sweaty $300 shirt. I think this is worth $300. Who said 300? Who said 300? 320. Okay, wait, you said 300, and who said 320? What did you just buy? The Slytherin scarf, right? What's that? You just bought the Slytherin scarf. There's one more item coming. It's not Harry Potter, because I see a theme with you. That's really, really cool. Do you want to save your money? Do you want to wait? Do you want to let her have it? Do you want to wait, see what's coming up? That's fair. 320. That's fair. 320.
What? You'll pay $300 for anything in the bag? He carries feces in that bag. It's a strange...
I've got some...
I can't explain... I've only known him for a few years, so he's never really...
Do you like Fruit Punch Crystal Light? I hope you do. Because it's expensive.
Oh, you're going to give her $40?
She's going to give you $40 so you can up your ante to $340. This woman just donated to you $40, so now it's at $340.
Oh, he's not...
$350.
Wait. This is going to be awesome. This is going to be so awesome. This is like nerd community coming together. And sir, I'm sorry, but you might be the underdog in this race now.
Or... The Slytherin.
Oh, the Slytherin. Yeah, by the way, conflicting houses, my friend. Okay, hold on. So we got 300 from you. We got 40 from you. We got 40.
And she's unemployed.
40 from you. You're going to throw in another 40 on top of her, so that's 380. 20. Can you beat 380? What?
Another 20.
Wait. 500. You are going to have no friends. Can we put the pot together for more than 500 for her? 100 between the two of you for her. 60.
You'll give her 100 if I sign your what now? I'll do that. So she's at 400, she's at least
no,
at 500.
No, I think she's at like 1,500. I have no idea how much money she's at right now. Let's just call it she's at 600 now. So can you beat 600? Okay, $600 to you,
Boom.
Ma'am. And we'll get it signed. We'll sign afterwards. Oh, you want to sign now? Okay, yeah, give her money right now. Yes. Raise your hand if you're giving her money. When did this become let's make a deal?
And then there was a gentleman, I was going to sign his lanyard. Let's not forget that. I was going to sign the gentleman's lanyard for $100.
Yes, let's get that man's lanyard. Get that man's lanyard.
Look at this.
Hey, and...
Damn it, you guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. You are awesome. Look what you've done. You united all these people against you. That was fantastic what you just did. What's the next question? Over here it means to my left. To my left.
Here.
God bless you.
Hi, Captain. What's the best prank you've done on set?
The best prank I've done on set. Probably nothing you haven't heard before, but I'll tell you this one. It wasn't even mine. Stana started this, told Seamus Dever, who was a vegan and decided to do this very strict diet, and he was on this kind of a cleanse. She told him that we were doing an episode in this male strip club, which was true, and that he and Esposito were going undercover and would have to get very nude. So he went on an even more strict diet. And I'm telling you, he was down to hard-boiled eggs and broccoli before the prank. So it was like half a glass of water and a cigarette, I think. She went so far as to get wardrobe to bring him like little Speedos and undies, like that said, "Kiss me, I'm Irish," that had sparkles on the back, that said Sparkles, like that was his name. For him to try on and to last pair of undies that came out for him to try on said, "Gotcha." That was a pretty good prank. That was a good prank. The next item up for bid. I don't know if any of you have keys, but this is a spaceship keychain. It's a Serenity keychain. I think it's worth $5.
$250? I love when you guys just jump to the top. That's like, let's cut to the chase here. $250? By the way, I would like to say this. I'm really glad that you are part of that last bidding war because you helped us raise so much money in that. So thank you. So we got $250 here. We got $275. 300, 320. Oh, wait, let me get this straight. 350, he can keep it and sell it again if he just signs your comic. Okay, so we're just gonna have your comic sign then and gladly take your money. Thank you, let's give her a round of applause. So, man, I could be making bank right now. This is insane. What was the last bid before that 350 then? Who was 320? 320?
Okay. Who said 320?
Right here.
Who said 300? I have two. I'll give you one for 300. I'll give you one for 300. She gets it signed for $300.
$300 for her signature for
the
comic?
For signature on her comic book?
Yeah.
That's $900 what would have been one keychain.
That's amazing.
Right?
Both sign. Who got these? Oh, here. I'd like your money first, please. Thank you. After the panel. We'll work it out. Don't worry. I'm not going anywhere. We're going to keep moving on, baby. We're going to keep moving on.
Next question. I love you so much, though.
Thank you.
It's you. Hello, sir.
Yes. First, I want to say thank you so much for that quick picture last night. I really appreciated it.
Who are you?
A lot of actors are famous mostly for one particular character, like, you know, Bruce Willis as John McClane, or, you know, you have two really famous characters, Mal and Castle. I was wondering, what do you look for in a script character-wise? What do you go, that's something that I would like to do?
Excellent question. One moment in a script will define a character for me. One excellent line that tells me this is the way it needs to be delivered in order to define exactly who this character is. I'll read through 2/3 of a script, get to that moment and say, ah, that's who he is, and go back to the beginning and reread it knowing now who this guy is. It's that moment that says, I know what to do. And when I got I was on Desperate Housewives at the time, I had a meeting in my trailer with the producers and creator of Castle, and I said, stop looking. I'm the guy. I was dressed in this very namby-pamby outfit, this kind of, you know, suburbanite. Hi, guys. barbecue? I said, ignore this. I'm actually pretty cool. And that one, the defining moment. That's what I look for. That's what I look for. Excellent question. Next item up for bid. I'm glad I was able to stop and have a photo with you last night. Sometimes I'm not able to stop. I have to be hustling through. And people, can I have a picture with you? I got an entourage of people shoving me through a door, and they're going, but I want a picture. And I feel, and they say, aw. Like I've let them down, and I hate that feeling. So what I did this year is I pre-signed a bunch of cards. And I say, I can't stop, but please, I pre-signed this for you. Please take a couple of these and pass them out with your friends over there. And on the back it says, please accept my apologies. Comic-Con is an amazing event, but it does place unique responsibilities on me. While I would relish the chance to stop for a photo, to sign something, or even just chat, my responsibilities lie with scheduled events, organized to reach as many fans as possible who have waited patiently in line, sometimes for more than an hour. Instead, please find my autograph on the back of this card. Tell your friends we met and had a laugh. I'll back you up. I got a stack of these. Why don't I just say, in fairness, why don't we just say $5 a piece?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, hold on.
wait. Take care of it. We're not gonna do it right now.
There's a lot of cards. How many cards? We're just trying to figure this out logistically here.
72. About $100. Wow. I'm a very good driver. Judge Wapner's on. Gotta see Judge Wapner.
Do we want to? Perhaps we can form a queue. After the panel?
That would be perfect. I'm going to let you arrange that.
Okay.
And Molly will keep an eye on you, make sure you don't steal any of those.
And the price of these are?
$5 a piece.
$5 a card. And we will be selling these immediately after the panel.
Next, how much time do we have left?
Oh, yeah, $5. Yeah, Jeff, your brother's saying $5 suggested price. Thank you. $5 suggested. If you want to give more, we would take it, but $5. Okay.
How much time do we have left? 20 minutes?
You know what? Just do your thing, baby. Done. Just do your thing.
And that's what makes a good boss. I'm so glad you're in charge, buddy. Right here.
Hi, from Australia, so I want to say that.
Hi.
Firstly, I want to say that we had our Castle fan dinner last night, and like we were coming out of the restaurant, and we saw you walking into the EW party, and it was a surreal moment for me. And speechless, so thank you for making that night more memorable.
Well, that was easy.
My question is, in an interview you once said that you liked how UK series end strong and not let a show just wither and die.
That's true, I said that.
How would you like Castle to end?
Season 6. On a very special castle. Two characters die. And it looks like the rest are going to die. As written by Joss Whedon. I was on a TV show once, and I can't remember what day we aired. I think we were a Tuesday show, and on Wednesdays, everybody would get the ratings. You get the fast overnights, which are sort of accurate, and then you get your proper ratings. And everybody's going, are we gonna get canceled? Are we gonna get canceled? It's a terrible feeling. It's a terrible feeling, but it taught me not to fret about stuff that is not within your control. It's within my control to get to work on time, to be pleasant, to be prepared, to do a good job. That's what I worry about. Ratings, I try not to worry about, but it's kind of a cloud. It's kind of a looming cloud. It's kind of hard to ignore a thunderhead right above you lightning ready to strike at any moment. That's a little bit stressful. So yeah, I'd want to end strong. Boom. This is it, boys and girls. It's over after this. I want everyone to be there for that and go, that was good. Right? Not like a different show that might have 5 episodes left. They say, wrap it up. Like Angel. Right? You got 5 left. That's true. The next item up for... I just found more of these. The first ones were signed in black, but the second, blue. How did this get in here? I have the world's smallest walkie-talkies. I'm a gadget guy. I love little pieces of crap like this. It's absolutely true. I said this is worth $5.
Done. Sold to the man for $40. Nice! Hey guys, don't worry. We'll get this to you right after the. Anybody who won anything in this insane generosity from Nathan today, if you haven't already gotten it, just stick around after the panel. We'll make sure that we get this to you, and we'll take your money very nicely. Okay, great.
Next question is over. Who's got the microphone? Stand up, lady.
Hi, I actually it's more of a very small request.
Let's start with what's your name?
I'm Nikki.
Nikki.
Yes.
Nathan.
Nice to meet you.
The pleasure's mine.
And I'm here because 2 of my best friends are here with me too. Megan, who's right down here waving very, very shyly.
Megan, stand up.
And
Megan,
my,
blush.
And my very best friend. And my best friend, Kate, who's up somewhere in the center.
Kate, stand up.
Right there.
And hi.
It's because of them that I am learning about Firefly and Castle and all of these wonderful things. So
thank
I just
you.
Was wondering if you'd give them a little personal shout out since we're here.
Ladies, it's because of people like you. And this is going to sound goofy, but this is actually, I'm going to be serious. It's because of people like you, friends like you. That I'm here for a show that lasted 13 and a half, kind of 1 2-hour episode, kind of right, like barely half a season, that I'm here 10 years later, and that's the only reason I'm here. So thank you very much. And I got a feeling there's more people like you in this crowd. That's a knowing nod right there. So thank you guys. Thank you very much, everybody. So, this is another DVD, Justice League Doom. I'm in it as Green Lantern. If we open, can we open that? I think that's worth $5. Done, 40, 40 and what? $100 and you get a picture with me. Yes? 120, 160, 200, 250. 250 and a photo with me. 360 and a photo with me. 260. 260. Yeah, okay, good. 260 and a photo with me. That's nice. Happy Mother's Day. I think I'm going to wrap it up right there.
Fantastic. 300 and a mom pic.
Do you have it to... What's your mother's name?
Mary Jane.
Mary Jane, do you have a moment to step up here really quick? Do you have a camera? Come up here, Angel. Come on over here.
Oh, nice.
Come on over here. Forgive me, I'm a little sweaty. You make me nervous.
That's, by the way, one of the sweetest, most generous things ever, to get a picture with your mom like that. Eric, did you get some pictures of that?
Yeah. You take pictures like my Aunt Adeline.
We'll get you some great pictures. Eric we'll Blackman's sure taking some great pictures in the back right now, yeah.
Now, you have a microphone. Did you bring that with you? I assume you have the next question, if that's why you have a microphone in your hand. We'll just go. We'll get you the next guy next, and then why don't you stand up and.
I'm not sure I can talk.
How you feel?
What I wanted to ask or say to you is that I've been online with a friend of mine in Germany, who her name is Katrin, and she wanted to know if you realized what a big following Castle has in Germany.
When people ask me when they say, "Oh, what do you do for a living?" and I say, "I'm an actor." And they don't know anything about me. They say, "Oh, are you any good?" I always say, "I'm huge in Germany." When films and television go to other countries and they want to dub into a different language, they'll use a particular actor. So when you continue to work, so does that actor. The actor that does me in Germany is the same guy who does Christian Bale's Batman. So all my characters sound like this. Sprechen Sie Deutsch.
Everything in Norway is in English.
As that would be lovely. They don't dub it? She watches
all
perfect.
TV
good.
Shows are in English.
Oh, good, originals. Good, good. Well, Serenity, I went there and I watched it in German, and it was weird.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for that question. That was sweet. The next item, and I'm going to say final item. Oh, I got more of these. Which also means if you see me and say, "Can I have one of those?" It's gone. The final item. When you're working on a set and you have a trailer where that's the only place you can go and kind of that's your space. If you want a moment of quiet, that's where it is. Because if you're on set, everybody wants your time every minute of every day. If you want to read a little bit of a book, good luck. So getting from the set to your trailer, that takes a couple minutes, and then getting from the trailer back to the set also takes a couple minutes. If you can shorten that time up, those minutes become your minutes. What I do is I use the Zooter. It's got a magnesium deck, it's extra wide for big feet. It's low to the ground, so you don't have to reach down so far to kick. It's telescopic, it comes down, and then it folds up with a simple locking pin. It's got a front brake, rear brake, and the ladies love it. I put some stickers on it. I got Blue Sun. I got the name of her, Serenity. And right here behind the strap, the convenient shoulder carrying strap, is Darth Vader. I think this is worth $5. It's got amazing bearings. These things will spin.
Wait.
One kick.
Wait. 500? Sue just said five. Oh. What do you do for a living, sir?
What did I tell you?
We're not going to get into one of those again. $500. $500 from you, sir. Can anybody beat that just by themselves? $550. $600.
That's fair. That's fair.
$650? $700?
That's really generous.
700 once, 700 twice, 700 gone.
Boom.
Now you can ride around on your scooter with your Slytherin flapping in the wind. Look at me. I'm made of money. Thank you so much, by the way. Thank you so much. Let's hear it for this guy. Excellent. Thank you.
What is your name? Jimmy. Not only are you one of my favorite people today, you're number two. Not only are you one of my favorite people today, but in purchasing this vehicle, I am in no way responsible or liable for any damages or injuries that might be, that you or any of your friends may incur. And I'm gonna need a ride back to the convention center, so I'll just be on the back. Hold it tight. Goodbye, Serenity. You've been a good girl. You go. Get out of here. I don't love you anymore. Run. Ride. Say goodbye to Molly before you go. Good times. Good times. I think I'll get a new one. All right. Next question.
Hi. I was lucky enough to get into the Firefly panel on Friday.
Me too.
Yeah, right. and I was in there for community before, and they were saying about all the online support that they get. If the internet had been as it was back when Firefly was on, do you think the online community may have saved it?
Why did I bark like that? I honestly think that, yeah, well, I don't know if it would have saved it. Okay, I can't guess. But I would say that the internet has an amazing way of uniting people. And Comic-Con is an excellent example of this because you guys plan for a year. Where are we going to stay? Who's crashing at my place? We'll use my car. I just got a new transmission. This all happens over the internet. What are we going to do Saturday morning? We don't have a plan for Saturday morning. I'm going to be throwing up in the bathroom. You guys get some breakfast burritos. It's all planned on the internet. No one gets to Comic-Con and go, so what now? You all know what you're going to do. You've been planning it for months on the internet. There is a unifying power of the internet. If you want to find someone who's totally into Malcolm Reynolds, but would rather he be in love with Kaylee, there's a support group for that. I'm in it. I'm also in the one with River and Jane and Wash, Simon, Book. And a new one, I just started, Mal on Mal. All right. I just wrote that. Next item up for bid.
What, you got a jetpack in there?
Is a Tide stain stick. I think that's worth $5. Who said five? $5 sold. I said sold. Good luck. N.F. I ran out of room. Nice. Next item up for bid. A silver and gold Sharpie. When you're at Comic-Con and famous, you gotta have a couple of these on hand at all times, because sometimes someone hands you something that black's not gonna show up on, or blue, or gold, so use the silver.
We have 10 opening here.
Who says 10?
Over here.
50 if what now? I'm a little sweaty, so I'll bust it down to 40 for you. $40, the pen's a sweaty hug. $60, a pen and a sweaty hug. $100, a pen. $120, a pen and a sweaty hug. Wow. I'm gonna sweat more often. What was that you said? Two something? We're gonna need a number. It don't work like that. What did you say? 150? 200? 232, the pens and a sweaty hug. Sold.
Oh.
Come get it. What's your name, Angel? Jamie, come on up here. Here is your, whoa, not so fast. I think we got a little business to take care of. Thanks. Oh. What's your question?
I named my son, who's 4 years old, Nathan.
It took you till he got to four?
No. And I almost hit your birthday. I'm a day early. March 26th.
Lucky little bastard.
My question, was it a mistake? Did people make fun of you as a child? Is there something that Nathan rhymes with? I don't know about. Adam Baldwin, maybe? Might have come up with something. You know, like, you don't want to be Flabby Abby, or did anyone ever make fun of you because of your name?
Excellent question. You can go. My mom wanted to go with Nathaniel. First, my parents wanted to go with Matthew, but I have a brother named Jeff. Jeff, can I introduce you to my brother? That'll be $300. You get me later. I take Canadian. First, my parents were going to name me Matthew, but from Matt and Jeff, my parents were afraid they would get Mutt and Jeff.
Yes, true. Very true.
Which at the time was a cartoon of two men that lived an alternative lifestyle.
I don't think that was the cartoon.
Oh, okay. The other reason... then they were going to go with Nathaniel, but my dad thought I would get beat up, so they went with Nathan. And wherever we are, it doesn't matter who knows us. When they mention our names, his always goes first. It's Jeff and Nathan. I keep pushing for Nathan and Jeff. Never flies.
Obviously.
Jeff, how has been your Comic-Con experience so far?
I've got to say... I've experienced joy, I've experienced tears. Today, you've made me cry a few times, Nathan, and so has the generosity of the people. No, really, there's been too much tears. This Comic-Con is supposed to be more laughter, so let's just pick it up a little bit. And you are a little bit sweaty, so.
This is true.
But Comic-Con is amazing, Nathan. I love it.
I'm very tight with my brother. We always have a great time. This is our time in the summer. We get to hang out for a couple weeks. When I was younger, I had a night job, but I wasn't making a lot of money, and I was driving a huge truck that my uncle sold me. It took so much gas. It just took everything I could to get my gas into the truck. My brother was a bartender on the university campus where we attended school. He made money hand over fist. I was parked behind my fraternity, the Kappa Alpha Literary Society, and I didn't have a parking pass. I got my truck towed. I already had a couple tickets on it, which meant I would have to pay the impound and the tickets. I called my brother. I said, "Dude, my truck got towed." He said, "No problem. I'll be right there." He took my little 50cc Yamaha Townie scooter from the south end of town, rode it 45 minutes to the university in crappy weather to my frat house, gave me the scooter, said, "Here's the address of the impound place." I called them, "Here's what it's going to cost to get your car at a Hawk. Throw your scooter in the back, but I'm going to need a ride home tonight." I said, I have no idea when I could possibly, this is more money than I'd held in my hand ever. I said, "I don't know when I'm going to be able to pay you back." His response, "No sweat, don't worry about it." Right? I know families that don't get along so great. I know people who are not tight with their family and their brothers, and I feel badly for them because my brother's thing has never been sibling rivalry. It's always been, he's always just made my life a lot smoother. And that's, I think, what family's all about. Kind of a brown coat thing, I think. Even though he's Slytherin. I think that's it.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I'm so sorry. I have to tell him to shut up now. No.
We went over time.
No, I really do. He needs to shut up. No, I'm kidding. What's that?
We did a good thing today. We did good stuff.
Oh, my gosh. Hey, how exciting was this? Oh, actually, hey, you want to actually one more thing?
Yeah.
We can do a T-shirt. We can do a T-shirt. And then, by the way, and anybody who spent any money on anything that Nathan auctioned off today, just make sure you stick around afterwards. And we'll make sure that we get everything to you. We'll get all that, excuse me, we'll get all that signed. Huh? Over here at the Vizio section, over here. Oh, and also anybody who was going to do a picture, any pictures, like the photo booth, I'll be right here at this photo booth instead. So we're going to queue you guys up that way.
And I'll meet you there, young lady. Make sure we get a proper photo. We'll meet there at the photo booth over in the corner.
Yes, at the photo booth.
It's a white box in the corner. Yeah. We'll make sure we get a proper photo.
And just so you guys know, because of the $5,000 that you guys spent on your seats, the $5,000 that Intel matched, and the now $5,000 that we just raised in this auction, this panel alone is $15,000.
That'll be $300.
Guys, let's give it up for Nathan Fillion, please. Are we exiting people out 6th Street? Wow, I really wish I could talk right now. I know it's a little better than last year, isn't it? Hey, a few dollars for what? $50 from me,
Zach,
or from Nathan?
Here's your shirt that we forgot to auction.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow, we got to auction this. Wait, hold on.
I say that's worth $5.
I'll sign.
I'm going to walk away because that was such a strong point to leave. I don't want to.
Oh, no. Well, good. I think he's going to pay you $50 for one last question.
I'll take
question. 50. Yeah? Is it a $50 bill? I don't want to change anything, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And what's your question?
I came from Australia. My wife couldn't come with me. And when I said, "What do you want me to bring back from Comic-Con?" she said, "Nathan Fillion." I came to a compromise and I said, "Well, I'll ask him to sing Happy Birthday because when I get back, it's her birthday. Could you do that for me, please?"
What's her name?
Rosalie.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. What was her name again? Rosalie. Happy birthday, dear Rosalie. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. Nathan Fillion, everybody. Thank you. All right. Nathan's already signed it. I'll get this done. What's the opening bid?
100 over here.
That's so weird because your voice is coming out of the speaker. What was it? 130 pounds? 100 British pounds? That's like $200. She took all your money? You know what? I'm just going to give it to you. How's that sound? I'm just going to give it to you. Here you go. I really hope that you guys, does it feel like it's really special? Does this feel like it's just like, you don't know what the hell's going to happen, it's just going to happen? I can't say anything more on top of that, so I'm just going to stop talking. Thank you guys so much. Thank you for being here at Nerd HQ. Thank you for all the money you've raised. I love you guys so much. Bless you. And is anybody going to Jared Padalecki later? What's that? I know. This is my sister, Shekinah. Let's give it up for Shekinah. We're criers. It's so weird. I'm sorry. I asked you and then I didn't listen. Who's going to Jared Padalecki? All right. Who's coming to my panel after that? I can't wait to see you guys. I'll be over here making sure your stuff gets signed. I'll be at the photo booth. I love you. God bless you, and see you in a second.